Ixigo was launched in 2007 as India's first meta search engine, with an aim to make travel a memorable, carefree, and affordable experience for its customers. It entered the market with an aim to become a one-stop destination that caters to all your travel needs, from mode of travel to hotel, and experiences that add that extra touch to your holidays.
There were lots of online travel agencies, there were airlines in the market. What was missing was a meta search. A meta search is essentially somewhere where you can compare prices from multiple sources like online travel agencies or airlines. Given that Indian customers or consumers are very, very price sensitive, we thought this was a good value proposition. It was also unique.
Their first day saw nearly 10,000 hits on their website. And with a server based in the US, Ixigo's search results were quick and in real time. But getting the airlines to buy into their idea wasn't an easy task.
In those days, we were more of a lead gen, so we were tracking how much traffic we were giving to the airlines. And we had a very good conversion rate, like we were able to funnel, 10 to 15% of our traffic into the airline website.
The founders, along with their team, were on a mission to make Ixigo every Indian traveler's favorite app.
Early 2008, we managed to raise a seed round from a Singapore-based fund who was introduced to me by one of my professors from INSEAD. So we were quite excited. It was our first major round of funding. We started hiring more people, shifted to a large office, started spending on marketing, kind of got into the hyper-growth mode.
Flush with funds, Ixigo used the money to move into a bigger space and hire more people. Not only did they sign up all the leading airlines, but they also added new verticals, such as hotels, and new advertising and a lead gen-based business model started to emerge. But with the financial market crashing in 2009, all their potential venture capitalists simply vanished.
The 2008 Lehman Brothers crisis actually started, so all our term sheets broke down. We had about 25 employees by then, so we got them all together and said, hey, we're going to run out of cash now, and we either find a way to survive, which means that we'll have to let a lot of people go, or we find another way forward. And I remember one of the young engineers at the time stood up and said, why can't we all just work without salaries for a bit?
The next 12 months were fantastic for the company, and Ixigo continued to grow despite the problems faced. The revenues went up 3 times, and employees were back on their original salaries.
That episode taught us an important lesson, which later became part of our culture as well. I think that one decision changed the way Ixigo is today. It's a very important part of our culture, which is transparency.
When you're forced against the wall with nothing, you find ways to fight back and survive, and then you invent or reinvent yourself. So we've done that a couple of times.
Ixigo had come out of the woods boldly, continuing to grow and innovate faster than anyone else in the market. They were by now getting about 1 million monthly visitors on their website.
I think one of the cornerstones of the Ixigo story has been our resilience and our ability to survive without a lot of capital, and that really built the culture of frugality and the culture of finding a path forward that helps you grow without requiring significant amount of capital. That's pretty unique to our story, I think.